Last is about, you know, convalescent plasma therapy, and this therapy generated a lot of hope in the beginning. And however, after, you know, publication of RCT's results, the hopes that they were dashed, and like any other therapy which are available for COVID patients, if this therapy is used early in the course of the disease, it may, you know, confer certain benefits. So, I mean, the people who are sitting behind me, our clinicians, they will also, you know, agree that a lot of, you know, public perception is driving the use of this convalescent plasma therapy in our patients and all over India also. So he was the first resident there who donated convalescent plasma at our center. So we know that currently we don't have any approved treatment for COVID-19, and this convalescent plasma, it is plasma which is collected from persons following resolution of COVID infection and development of neutralizing antibodies against COVID. And historically also, it has been used in many viral diseases, but the outcome, they are different, and some studies they have advocated the use, and some they have not found any, you know, benefit by CP. As regard to COVID patients, we have, you know, off-label use wherein the moderate category of patients who are not improving, you know, despite use of fistoriate, their oxygen demand is increasing, they may be provided this therapy. It all depends if there are antibodies which are neutralizing in nature, they can block, they can bind to the virus, and they can stop the replication. And as you know, the entry of the virus into cell depends on the receptor binding domain of the spike protein of SARS and its receptors. And there are many antibodies which are acting against the RBD region of the virus, so they can neutralize it. Non-neutralizing antibodies, they're also important, and they can improve the recovery of the patients. So majority of the patients of COVID, they normally have high titers of antibodies after 2 weeks of resolution of their symptoms. And although 30% of the patients, they may not develop sufficient high titer antibodies, neutralizing antibodies following infection. So neutralizing antibodies, there were a lot of, you know, hue and cry, the criteria, they were being changed. And FDA, US FDA said that titer more than 160 and above, it should be used if it is there in the donor plasma. Recently, the ICMR has, you know, said that, okay, the neutralizing antibody titer, it can be 1:80. It is just very recent, just hardly 10 days back, these, you know, guidance, they have come up. Or if one is using, you know, ELISA, then the IgG titers should be 640. If somebody is using CLIA, that is chemiluminescence-based assay, depending on which company you're using. So these are different, you know, parameters. At our center, we are taking, we are using Vitros equipment, and we are taking signal to cutoff ratio of 12, and we are collecting, you know, plasma which contains high titer IgG antibodies against spike protein. So it is presumed that if there are antibodies and they can neutralize, you know, virus, they can affect. So in many studies, at least one ray of hope is that many patients, they are becoming RNA negative very early. And it is also said that viral load, it correlates significantly with the pro-inflammatory cytokines. So if you can stop the viral load, if you can somehow decrease the, you know, viruses, so there is, I mean, theoretically it is said that there will be reduced tissue damage and inflammation. There's one very good article in Science, and it said that some plasma donation from severe disease patients could harbor the interferon neutralizing antibodies. So at least 10% of the patients who are having severe COVID disease, they can have interferon neutralizing antibodies. These are IgG in nature. And if these are present, they will, you know, knock down this interferon, and which are important for viral defense. So such persons or such, you know, donors, they should be removed from the pool of convalescent plasma donors. The dose in many studies, it has ranged from 200 to 500 in a single or double doses in most trials. ICMR advocated 2 aliquots of ABU compatible 200 ml each 1 day apart. And recently, DGHS, Government of India guidelines, they said that 200 ml single dose given slowly over not less than 2 hours. Monitoring response, it may be by clinically by PF ratios or radiologically, or there are some certain endpoint also which may be used. As such, there are not many contraindications, but of course, if some person is having simultaneous immunoglobulins infusion, this severe shock or severe thrombosis, or in pregnancy and breastfeeding. Side effects are, there's one theoretical possibility of ADE, which was seen in dengue patients also, but it has not been confirmed in, you know, till now in COVID patients. And another thing is that many patients are already, you know, hypercoagulable stage, so it may aggravate, you know, thrombotic profile in such patients if you are giving, you know, two doses of plasma, and other usual adverse transfusion reactions to plasma, that is Traline, allergic and anaphylaxis reactions may also be seen. But altogether, this therapy is, you know, almost safe. These are the few steps which are involved in convalescent plasma therapy. Normally, the latest guidelines now say that after 14 days of symptoms resolution, the donor, they can donate convalescent plasma. Now, this COVID-19 testing negative report is not mandatory, which was required earlier. So we need to first recruit, we need to assess our, you know, COVID patients for plasma collection. Once they have recovered completely, it may be by plasmapheresis or by whole blood derived convalescent plasma, it can also be used. And we have to then do the IgG antibody detection and titration, then TTI markers for all the viral testing like hepatitis and hepatitis B and C and HIV and other investigations which are carried out. And thrombolastography, which we have, you know, done in certain you know, patients, if we think that the patient is having, you know, hypercoagulable picture. There are certain issues involved in CPT. Currently, we're not getting, you know, I mean, enough voluntary donors, and we have stopped, you know, asking for the replacement, you know, convalescent plasma donors now. And our majority of the donors, they are asymptomatic or they had, you know, mild disease when they were affected with COVID. And the cost of antibody detection kit is too high. It's costing around 700 to 800 rupees per test, and uniform guidelines, they are not being followed, you know, for convalescent plasma therapy. And because we get many requisitions which are for, you know, patients who are in the late stage of their, you know, disease, or patients are on ventilator. So there are certain issues. This is one, you know, trial from ICMR, PLACID trial, which changed the whole, you know, thing. And this trial said that progression to severe disease or all-cause mortality at 28 days after enrollment, I mean, it didn't help much as regard to the progression to severe disease or to mortality at 28 days. However, there are certain patients who had, you know, slight, you know, clinical improvement as regard to shortness of breath and fatigue. And many patients, they converted, they became RT-PCR negative, you know, with the use of this convalescent plasma. However, this study, it was criticized being because it was open label design, and the antibodies, they were not measured before, you know, transfusion, because kits were not available at the time in India. And most of the donors, they had mild disease. So that is why it was presumed that they all had, you know, low titers of antibodies, neutralizing antibodies, so that it was not found effective. So these are the various RCTs. So I'll just take two more minutes. Okay, sir. Okay. So most of these studies which have been done in Argentina, Spain, India, they say that this is not effective. And because in one study, almost three studies, they were stopped, you know, prematurely, and it was found that patients, they had, you know, up to 50% of the, you know, patient, they had antibodies, IgG antibodies. One here you can also see it was done in Netherlands. It was terminated early. Almost 80% of the patients at the time of enrollment, they had, you know, antibodies. So most of these studies, they don't favor, you know, convalescent plasma, especially in sick patients who are critical. So our data shows that we had, you know, 72 convalescent plasma donation, 54 voluntary, and this is like the patients. This is important that we have given, you know, this therapy to 116 patients, and many of our patients, they received plasma from outside also, so their data is not with me. And so 50 patients, they were, you know, discharged. 45 patients, they expired, and they were mainly from the serious group, critical group. So recovery was almost, you know, 55%. So this is one, like what we did, we randomly selected a few patients, and what we found that these RCS patients of COVID, they had, you know, already developed antibodies, IgG antibodies. So before, you know, we gave this thing conventional plasma. So you will see that those patients who were admitted, who had, you know, symptoms, symptomatology less than 7 days, so almost 12%. And 77% of our patients, they had IgG antibodies by the time, you know, from 7 to 14 days. Beyond 14 days, almost 100% of the patient, they had antibodies. So there is no point, you know, giving conventional plasma, which is having allogeneic antibodies, if the patient has developed autoantibodies. And that is true for, you know, 14 days, you know, patients, if have, you know, they have symptomatology, you know, of 14 days. So this is one, you know, directive came from Government of India in 1st July. They said it has to be used in moderate category of patients. And this proforma we prepared in September, and wherein we indicated that moderate disease, you know, in this therapy may be used in patients where symptoms they have in less than 7 days. If IgG antibodies are not present before transfusion, or if there is a mild titer present, and it should not be used if symptomatology is more than 14 days, or IgG antibodies are present in patient before transfusion, or if there is a patient who is on ventilator. Similarly, after, you know, more than 1.5 months, now recently after 10 days back only, ICMR has, they have revised their guidelines, and they have given a decision matrix. And this says, that is not clear here, so that is why I have taken this slide, that indiscriminate use of CPT is not advisable. And they have said that the presence of antibody against COVID-19 in a potential recipient makes transfusing conventional plasma a futile intervention. So that is important. So just to sum up, this ICMR advisory says that a potential recipient of conventional plasma, they should only include who are consenting, who are in the early stage of COVID-19 disease, up to 7 days of the onset of symptoms, but not later than 10 days, and no IgG antibody should be present in the patient, in the recipient. So just to take home message, that off-label use in selected patient, it may be used, conventional plasma. So it all depends how we are selecting our donors and how we are selecting our patients. That's all from us.